I thought it would push me luck, and with a bit of WD-40 the exhaust studs came out quite easily. Of course, with the other end being in the cylinder, they've been constantly heated and cooled, so I always got in, which is great. It took me a little while to work these out because of the carbon build up, but what we'll do is fill this up with paraffin and set fire to it and burn out all the carbon. But I'll try and get this set apart, this side of it rather, apart, so I can get the gasket out and remake that. Otherwise I'll end up burning that out as well. It's the easy way to remove carbon from the old exhaust pipe expansion chamber. A load of paraffin soaked rags in the bucket. It's all burning off a treat. Might even free up the two studs that I can't undo. Smells great. Oh, all the carbon's coming out as ash, which is the idea. So just now it's cooled down enough so it doesn't ignite again. I've squirted a bit of WD-40 onto those nuts there. Never know, I might be able to get them undone. So we'll give that a soak in the paraffin bath when it's cooled off, and that should do the job. Well, I'm just going to knock up a new paper gasket for the cylinder. Really easy. You need a ball peen hammer, sheet of gasket paper, and to make life easier, you'll want four bolts that fit the holes. We start by cutting out the hole in the middle where the cylinder is, obviously. Next part, you want to find the bolt holes. So there's one there, one there, one there, and one there. Being a two-stroke, it has a port just there, so I'll cut that out next. See, the gasket's going to be very thin between the cylinder wall and the port. So a bit of care needed. Now the bolts, you can put those in just to keep the gasket where it is. As easy as that. One gasket for Villiers WX-11. Cylinder's back on, tightened down, exhaust fitted, and she's now got sensible levels of compression again. Not as much as it should have, but it's certainly better for having removed the rings, cleaned the piston and so on. I also honed the bore very lightly. Just one more thing to show you. I had a new core plug at last year's Ringmer Steam Country Show. I filled it up with water and it all came pouring out. Luckily I was able to get a new core plug from the tractor shop, tractor stall, and soon had it fitted. Not quite correct, it should really be the other way around, but I found I couldn't fit it like that. It just wouldn't go, so had to opt for that way around, dish the inside in. But again, it's something I can put right if I do a proper rebuild on it. It's worked very well. Just having a nosy around the carburetor, I noticed that the jet tube was quite loose. Now, all the other Villiers carbs I've come across, the jet tube, this bit, is pretty firm in the body of the carburetor. These are all off ATCO lawnmowers, and they yield enough spare parts to keep things like this going, so they're quite handy. Just be aware, if you're doing one of these, the needle there that stops the flow of fuel can drop out, so be careful once you've taken the jet tube out. Anyway, yes, it was loose, so what I've done, I've managed to pinch a seal out of another carburetor, one of those spare ones, so I'll try that. If it needs another one, then we'll do the same again. Of course, lifting this up, so I'm then going to have to reset the fuel needle, which is done on this adjuster here. But we'll do that with the engine up to full temperature. Other thing to watch with two-strokes, of course, is you get a lot of muck build up. Say you leave the engine over winter. See a bit in there, so seemed worse, but a lot of sediment came out. In fact, you can see it all over the O-ring there. So it needs a good old clean-up. Finish getting it put back together. Just need to check the tension on the generator tomorrow, give it a little test run. I did just pop some petrol down the plug hole, span it over and it fired, so magneto's good at least, or got some kick in it. So it should have been a recon unit. Just cleaned the plug, so it's all ready to go tomorrow. The carburetor has been totally stripped and cleaned. It's worth saying that the nut on the end of the float bowl there does actually pull the jet down onto those seals, but the jet tube was loose even with that nut tightened up, so obviously there weren't the number of seals there should have been. And from my experience of the few of these carburetors I've worked on, there are a varying number of shims depending on how the components were made. Sort of the seals, the shims, whatever you want to call them, were used to take up the tolerance, and as you can see, there's no movement in that. Can't shift it, so we've got a good seal there. Hopefully improved running, and I'll be able to get the proper setting on the float needle. So get it warmed up and get it tuned in. Hi folks, we're back working on the generating plant today. One thing that's bothered me with the engine is the speed that it runs. It's a bit too slow, and I don't think it's helping with the oiling plugs. And slightly temperamental running when it's cold, just wants to go a bit faster. So as you can see, I found a pulley that's a little bit bigger. Had a ferret round in the scrap bin. It's an old washing machine pulley, I think. I put a bolt through the faceplate with a washer, basically the same size as that, so that once tightened up, that pretty well centered it up. Had about 20 thou run out, so then loosely tightened up these things, which are a bit crude, but it worked. And then I was able to dial it in with a DTI. Got about 5 thou run out, so that's all right. Faced and bored it through, and I'm off to go and see what that aeroplane is. Probably a Harvard thing like that, but I'll blow up the image on the computer later, see what that was. Anyway, bought it out to about 19mm and just face that off. Just looks a bit nicer. I'll clean it up, fit it, and see how she goes. What I am going to have to do though, obviously I'm going to have to move it along these slides. They're actually uni-strap. I shall make something better one day. Which might mean moving the bolts that hold the slides down, but we'll see how we go. Seems to be running pretty nice now. The whole plug, that's all it was, falls into this far. you go. As you can see, it was running quite well in the end. I had to tweak the points gap. It was a little bit large, so I sorted that out. Lubricated the cam while I was there as well. Also changed spark plugs. Didn't seem to like the other plug for some reason, so got another one in there, Champion 8 com. It seems to go very well with that. Nice clean exhaust. Before it used to dribble all out of there, the gap there, and also at the bottom. So that's nice. Much less smoky once it's warmed up. So once it all warmed through, it cleared the paraffin that I'd used to clean the sub base. So yeah, it's running pretty well, and I reckon for a day's running, that'll allow me to get it properly hot and set the carburetor up, get it running even slightly better. Certainly better running fast like that. Can handle the full 25 amp load much better. The pulley's not the most aesthetically pleasing thing, but it's just to test if that size of pulley works alright. And I'll probably get another taper lock one to fit. I'm going to include this in my display for the Ringmer Rally, because I've got lots of paraffin lamps to display with the engine. Bought this a couple of weeks back at a little show I did, and I've just photoshopped an enamel sign, a scan of an enamel sign for the transfer, which I've then printed. A lot of these words and letters were missing. I've, like, half of that F there was missing, so I've reconstructed that with Photoshop. Got rid of a load of rust patches, but it kind of looks right, so I'm well pleased with that. Alright, so look out for this one at the Ringmer Steam and Country Show. That's next weekend.